Mr. Srinivasan, thank you very much for speaking to me on Frankly Speaking. I've been waiting for a very long time for this opportunity. The show is Frankly Speaking. And I have just one thing to say to you. I want you to answer all my questions to the best of your ability. And I will listen to you completely, but I also want you to listen to every question that I put to you. So we have a free and frank conversation on this.
Agree.
Agreed. Mr. Srinivasan, morally and ethically speaking, does your conscience allow you to be functioning as the BCCI president?
See, it depends on how you look at it. You know, I'm a very firm believer in standing up for what I do. I realize, you know, if you really want me to speak frankly, I won't call it a debate, but I have been the victim of a concerted attack on this very same question by various sections of the media. The BCCI is a body, it's a private body. The members of the BCCI have expressed and reposed confidence in me. At the recently concluded annual general meeting of the BCCI, although it was a south turn and I was proposed unanimously, it was unopposed, still the question was put to the members by the secretary of the board that in spite of this, in light of all that has happened and all that has been stated, all the cases that were pending, were the members still unanimous in wanting me to be the president? The answer was yes.
Your son in differently. When the cricketers,
no, I think we'll get into an argument now.
No, no, Mr.
Because
Mr.
I'll explain.
Let me just.
No, I have understood your question. Your point. See.
Yes.
The phraseology, I do not remember. I do not remember exactly what I said. You may quote. I mean, that's okay. But so many things have been said about me also. Now, as far as this issue is concerned, the matter today, the Supreme Court has appointed a committee. Now, I did not appoint the previous committee. First, let us understand that very, very correctly.
You were the BCCI chief.
No, I was not. I had stepped aside. Excuse me. I had stepped aside. And the two judges were named by the committee when I was, after I had stepped aside, I had nothing to do. You can ask anybody. I did not go to the BCCI office. I did not get involved. So this was appointed by somebody else. They went into it, they gave a report, somebody went to court, went to Supreme Court. Supreme Court has given a decision, fine.
We'll come to the
probe. I'm not involved in that now.
We'll come into the probe aspect. You see, Mr. Srinivasan, in your first reaction, when the spot-fixing scandal broke, you said, and I quote, here, as you see, the people involved are Ranji Trophy players, and one of them is a test player.
I am not.
Let me ask my question.
Yes, but before that, I want to set certain things. You know, I agreed for an interview.
Yes.
But not to be put in the position of an accused. You know, because I am not accused of anything. See, as far as this whole issue is concerned, of the players, in my mind, there will never be a double standard. Secondly, I am not the person who has to decide on Gurunath Maiyappan. I am not the person who is going to decide. I am not the one who is going to be involved in it at all. Somebody else is going to be involved in it. So where is the question of a double standard here?
Take my question, Mr. My point was that you used the word shocking when it came to the case of the first spot-fixing scandal. Therefore, the question is it not shocking when the board president's son-in-law and a key functionary in one of the teams is also indulging in betting? In that case, you use the case and you use the phrase enthusiast. So here's the question.
I do not remember the words.
This is what you
have advantage of notes.
Yes.
See, I do not have
these
the advantage. No. They may be. I'm not saying, I don't say that you lie or you say untruth or anything of that kind. All I'm trying to put to you is that may be so, but this is not, you know, I'm not here on the stand to answer why you said this, why you didn't say this. No. Fact is, I stepped aside at that time. And this is not an item now. This is sub judice. Somebody is inquiring into it. I don't see, I mean, why we should go into this de novo all over again.
Because the question, initial question, Mr. Srinivasan,
and just like, and
of,
just like you
was
say,
of, was
and just
of,
Arnab conscious. also, no, you must allow me to, because you're making all kinds of accusations. Just like you say, that a lot of people are asking questions, there are a lot of people also supporting me who have conveyed to me, cricketers. We are talking of cricketers, we are talking also of cricketers who have also said, who have wished me well, they want me to stand up. It's both sides. You have the benefit of the television, you have the media,
Mr. Srinivasan, please, let's fundamentally ask the questions here, because today, this is being watched by a lot of people and they have these questions of you, and therefore, the allegations against your son-in-law, and that's the only question I have on conscience, broke out on the 26th of May. You stepped aside, that is, you stepped aside from temporarily not discharging your duties on the 2nd of June. But the fact is, Mr. Srinivasan, you know what happened in that intervening period. You went aside, but you went down kicking and shouting. You could have stepped aside.
I don't know how long I'm going to continue this interview,
do you feel that in retrospect, you should have completely set aside at that point of time and had a totally independent probe look into the whole matter? Would that have restored public confidence much more?
Excuse me, I do not think, I mean, your view on public confidence, I don't share, number one. Secondly, let me then, since you are asking me about my behavior, let me then, in which case, ask about how the media behaved. We will take one particular group and one particular newspaper. I was on the front page, occupying the entire front page, top, for almost 12 to 13 days. I'm not that important. BCCI is not that important. When all kinds of things were happening in the country. 81 pieces were written about me in that paper during the same period. And there were 10 or 11 editorials. Now, this is not news. This was a savage attack on me.
How do you determine that?
Pardon?
The entire national media, the entire national, and the Supreme Court said, the Supreme Court in a telling observation said, the fact is that
I agreed for an interview to frankly speak, but not for an inquisition.
No, there is no inquisition. The question is,
the question is,
Mr. Srinivasan, let's take your first argument. You say that I am not responsible for the actions of my son-in-law. This has been your principal argument. You agree with that? That this has been your principal argument?
See, now we are getting into an area where
yes,
the Supreme Court has asked a committee to go into whatever they have, which is all public knowledge
yes,
now. So I am not going to get involved in a discussion which is going round and round that, because a lot of it is sub judice. I do not want to get... Now, if you feel, it is, if in your opinion, you feel that what I said was not correct, it's up to you. As far as I'm concerned, I say that you went too far. I was not worth 81 articles, 12 editorials. I was not worth front page of newspapers.
Srinivasan.
I mean, it is.
But Mr. Srinivasan, you are.
No matter. BCCI is not that important. But no, this is my view. See, you have a different view.
Okay, then you let me have my view after you finish yours.
No, it's okay. I think this is no. Honestly, can we just?
Don't you feel, Mr. Srinivasan, that the BCCI represents cricket? It represents cricket lovers. Cricket lovers are across the entire country. And hence, when there is something that falls as a shadow on cricket, do you not believe, Mr. Srinivasan, that that is a very important issue?
Excuse me. I am not prepared to agree with you. I have done, according to me, I did not do anything wrong. I stepped aside. Matter was taken up. Maybe the media, maybe all of you wanted me to go. But since I was blameless, I stayed on. And maybe that is why, all this questioning. This is a, when the matter has been decided by the Supreme Court, and they have said something, now you are saying ethically, legally, now you are splitting legal and ethical.
No.
You are.
No.
Anyway, I think we disagree. I mean, on this issue, I do not agree with you.
Okay, fine. On the 26th of May, Mr. Srinivasan, you said, and this was a lot of material which came out in the media. You're aware of all this. There were pictures of Guru Nath in the dugout. There were visiting cards.
I am not.
There was a lot of evidence.
I am not.
At that point
I am
of time
not
regarding Guru Nath.
I am not going into the Guru Nath matter, which is now subject of a Supreme Court committee, which is going into it. I am not going to enter into that at all. Please. If you want me, and I think this interview we will close.
But why was don't you feel
no,
that was the
we'll
fundamental
close,
issue?
No, I think we closed the interview.
Now, don't you feel that was the fundamental issue at that time?
Excuse
then
me, how can I go into something which the Supreme Court has said that there will be a committee going into it? Why should I go and traverse that at all?
Did you react in the proper manner you feel when you said he was just an enthusiast? Was your initial inference correct, Mr. Srinivasan? Just tell me, because this is discussed hotly everywhere at that time.
See,
I want you to tell me whether you believe your initial inference was correct. That's all that I'm asking you. Why don't you tell me?
I am not going to enter into the Guru Nath discussion, because if that is what you want to drag me into, when it is a matter in a sense before the courts, I don't think it is proper for me to get into that discussion now. And if that is what you want to do, put me on a stand, go at newspapers, articles, and whatever is written at the period, which is going to be investigated, I'm sorry.
At that point of time, Mr. Srinivasan, okay, there was an investigation which was ordered. I won't ask you those questions because you're not prepared to answer the questions. Otherwise, there were a lot of people who
see, I cannot. I cannot go. Excuse me. I cannot. I cannot go into the questions which cover a matter which is now being investigated or being going to be probed. Why should I give a view on it?
But did the BCCI not settle the matter earlier?
Excuse me.
Do you believe? Okay.
If you had told me that you were going to sit and discuss about the probe, then I would have not agreed to this interview. I'm sorry.
Mr. Srinivasan, you don't want to discuss about Gurunath Mayappan?
I am not going to discuss this probe business, but you know, you have the benefit. I should have brought with me also the bunch of articles that were written and all the comments made. In fact, in your channel, somebody wanted me to be lynched. No, this is the extent to which you people went. And now I'm not prepared for the kind of
Mr. Srinivasan.
I would have also brought a bunch of the reports and records which I had.
Mr. Srinivasan, don't you believe at that point of time the entire country was discussing what was happening?
You wanted only to project that. You did not want the country to see anything else. Whatever else, people were killed in Chhattisgarh. That was not important.
Is the matter of match fixing, spot fixing, all these allegations, are these not serious allegations?
They're all serious allegations. They're being looked into by somebody else now. I don't want to comment on it. I keep saying that, but you want to drag me back into it.
At that point of time, did you not believe the image of cricket was being sullied?
The image of cricket, I see.
Yes.
When we have a fundamental difference of opinion, two of us, I think we will repeat what each other is saying. So I don't know. In the sense that I believe that things were, you know, that the media went overboard and I was savagely attacked. You believe what you did was right. So we have a difference of opinion. So what is the point in this?
In the first part of the interview, N. Srinivasan gets defensive when asked on Gurunath and his involvement with Chennai Super Kings. But those are not the only questions. In this part of Frankly Speaking, Srinivasan takes direct questions on the probe panel and the inquiry into spot fixing.
Mr. Srinivasan, now let's agree to continue this and to continue the conversation without your getting angry or my getting angry. Let's have an even, straightforward conversation, because I want you to appreciate this, that everybody watching this has questions, and the questions I'm asking you today are not on my behalf, but they are on behalf of several cricket lovers. And you must understand, Mr. Srinivasan, that as the president of the BCCI, you are the custodian of their faith. And therefore, it is important for me to ask you those questions. So let's proceed. Mr. Srinivasan, this investigation which you did. Now, there is a fundamental problem with this probe. It was rushed. It was hurried. It was closed without full documentary evidence of the Mumbai police being available to it. Why was it done in this manner?
Arnab, I'm trying to explain to you, and I think I was not responsible for setting up of this probe. This probe was decided after I had stepped aside. These two judges, this decision to appoint this was done in a working committee, either held in Calcutta or Delhi, possibly Calcutta, where I was not present. And that report was submitted again to the working committee, again when I was not present. I had already stepped aside, you see. So therefore, I don't see how I can answer this question, because I was not involved in the setting up. I had stepped aside on the 2nd of June. This committee, I think, was appointed on the 10th of June, when I had already stepped aside and said I will not get involved. And after the report was given, after that I was told, yes, that the report is completed, now you are free to, because I had said I'll step aside until the report is completed. The report has been completed, the working committee had received it and seen the report. Therefore I joined. Meanwhile, someone went to court, and they had already gone to court against the probe, a decision came, so again I stepped aside. Until the AGM came, and then the working committee decided, I was told that, you know, that I had to carry out statutory and constitutional functions so that the BCCI could function, the AGM could happen. And I stood for election. I mean, I was elected unanimously, like I said. So I was not, this is where the misunderstanding, I think you have to appreciate the fact that not. I was not involved at all. I am not the person to answer this. This is all I'm trying to tell you.
Yeah, but I'm asking you, because do you agree, Mr. Srinivasan, that there was some kind of an umbilical cord link between this probe panel being completed on the one side and your continuing as BCCI chief? Because the BCCI press release said that Srinivasan will not discharge his duties till such time as the probe is completed.
Yes.
You agree. And all this evidence is not considered. It was quickly rushed through.
Excuse me.
Was this, therefore, the probe panel basically set up to give you a clean chit in a short period of time?
No. You see, I think I'm not able to articulate sufficiently to explain this to you. Because I, again, repeat, the probe panel was appointed by a working committee where I was not present. I had stepped aside. That report was accepted by the working committee.
Yes.
Or they received. I was not there. I didn't even see the report. See, because I had no access to the report when it was placed there. See, you have to understand the fact, because when I said I stepped aside, I completely stepped aside. So this, if I had seen the report and said good report or something like that, that's okay. Different. I did not.
Okay. In that case, Mr. Srinivasan, there were two committees. There was Ravi Sawani committee, which is the head of the, as you know, the BCCI's anti-corruption unit, which looked into the allegations against Srisant and the others. In that case, that committee had a detailed meeting with the Delhi police, which had filed the charge sheet in spot fixing in the first place. Ravi Sawani refers to the details of the Delhi police charge sheet in his own report, which found Srisant guilty of spot fixing. Whereas in the case of this particular committee, it did not even meet the Mumbai police, Mr. Srinivasan. Is there a basic fundamental difference of approach, which in your view should be, can be questioned here, a lacuna perhaps, in the manner in which this was operated?
See, if you are asking me about the functioning of that probe committee,
yes,
I don't think I am the person to answer it, because I was not involved, number one. And all that is before a court somewhere. Please understand that. Secondly, as far as Srisant was concerned, the ACSU conducted I think if I'm not mistaken, Ravi Sawani was the commissioner of inquiry.
Yes.
And he submitted a report. In this case, a separate outside agency was appointed, two judges, by the BCCI, when I was not present. So they went into this matter. So it's not, you know, the issues I don't, and I was not involved, as I said, with the appointment, with the functioning,
yes,
with the Pope, how many meetings they held. I did not know, because I did not attend it.
But
and at the end of, and I did not see the report.
It does not strike you as odd that in one case of Srisad, they go and meet, have a meeting with the Delhi Police Commissioner.
See, I am not.
And, in see, the, and allow me to complete. And on the other case, they have no meeting. And there are four dates, Mr. Srinivasan, I want to bring to your kind attention. The four dates are the following. If the dates are incorrect, you can stop me. On the 28th of May, this pro panel is set up. On the 2nd of June, you step aside. On the 28th of June, a letter is sent by the pro panel to the
BCCI. May I make a small mistake?
To the BCCI.
May I suggest?
Yes.
There was a pro panel set up on the 28th of May,
yes,
or something, correct?
Yes.
But that panel was changed, and the working committee set up a panel of just the two judges on the 10th of June. When by which time I had already stepped aside. I think this is what is you're missing.
Okay. So even now, let's continue on the dates. Let's continue on the dates.
See, on the
28th of
June. One second. 28th of June, what you said is right, but then Sanjay Jagdale resigned. You know, he did not want to continue in that probe panel. Because he resigned as a secretary. Yeah. So I stepped aside. Then the BCCI working committee set up another probe panel, set up a panel on the 10th of
June. On the 28th of June, a letter is sent. One second. On July 5th, the Mumbai police. Mr. Srinivasan, one minute.
I have a small caveat.
Let me complete.
I have a small problem.
Let me complete my dates and then you ask. On the 5th of July, they send a response saying, why should we appear before you? Tell us the reasons why. On the 28th of July, without waiting for a response from the Mumbai police, there is a clean chit given. Now, in the given circumstances, which you are extremely upset about, which you believe were worked against you, in the given circumstances, do you not believe two things? One, BCCI, in whatever form, should have had nothing to do with any inquiry into this matter, given the grave questions being asked. Secondly, all the evidence, by which I mean every single ounce of evidence, should have been duly considered before the probe was to be submitted. If that were to happen, and if you were to come back after such an investigation, people would applaud you. Because it did not happen that way, the questions become graver, Mr. Srinivas.
If I see, I have a problem here. My problem is you're asking me to comment about the probe panel. The Supreme, you see, I am not the person to say whether the probe panel did a proper job or did not do a proper job. I did not set it up. I did not read the report. I was not involved. Again, I repeat it. So I cannot make any comment on the probe panel. You are asking me something which I can't answer. You are asking me all the time about this probe panel. Did they do it? How many meetings? Did they consider it? How do I know? Because I did not even see that report.
But you know why I'm asking you.
I did not set up that probe panel.
But you know why I'm asking you.
I do not know.
The reason I'm asking you is because there was a direct proportional relationship between the outcome of the probe panel and your return as the BCCI chief.
See.
Agreed or not?
How? You are trying to say.
Yes.
I was not involved with the probe panel at all. And you are keeping me, asking me about it. Now, this whole probe is now under the Supreme Court. Somebody is going to do it. The whole questioning is round and round this, on which I cannot, you know, I was not part of that. I stepped aside. I did not get it. I was not involved in any fashion with it. So how can I answer anything?
Do you not have sleepless nights now, Mr. Srinivasan?
Why should I have any sleepless nights?
Let me explain to you. The matter is not settled. You are, the first time I saw you smile in this interview, you are the BCCI chief. The court has told you you can discharge your duties, but with a very, very big caveat, Mr. Srinivasan. My question to you is, if in 4 months this new probe panel which has been constituted finds your son-in-law guilty, what will you do?
The Supreme Court has asked this probe panel to submit its report, and they have said, we will see. You see, this is a report that is going to the Supreme Court. Now, I am not going to make any comment on what would be the outcome, what they write. These are all, what you're asking is speculative in nature. I don't see why I should get involved. See, I make it very plain. I stayed out. I had stepped aside. I did not go anywhere near that probe panel. I had no knowledge what they did. Similarly, again, the Supreme Court has very clearly said that this, as far as this probe panel is concerned, basically said that I should stay away, but I should cooperate. I will do exactly what the Supreme Court has said. Let the report come at that point. I am not going to make any comment on with regard to anything that they may say. Please, I think this you should understand.
No, not with that outcome. But don't you feel your continuance, the same questions
that
will be raised?
I'm sure you will raise I don't want to speculate on this, please. As far as I'm concerned, you ask me, do I have sleepless nights? No. I sleep well.
A Damocles sword hangs over your head.
Your view.
Everyone's view.
Fine. But that doesn't mean all I can tell you is I sleep well. You can interpret it in any fashion. People can interpret it, but as far as I'm concerned, I sleep well. I have no issues.
Mr. Srinivasan, cricket in this country is not a private affair. And that's another fundamental point of disagreement that not just I, let me say this, a lot of people out there, everyone says this. That you know what, in our country, cricket is being run as a cozy club. The word cozy club comes up again and again. Cricket is not a private affair, Mr. Srinivasan. It resides in the hearts of a billion Indians. You can't say it's to be managed in the way a private society is to be managed.
I have no comment on it, you know, in the sense that I do not know what you're trying to get at. I think the BCCI is administering cricket well. The team is doing well. I think if I can, the BCCI has used its funds to create a lot of infrastructure, taken cricket throughout the country, has used its funds to help old cricketers, has given one-time benefits, created infrastructure, a lot of good things. I mean, the amount of things, the positive things that have been done by the BCCI, I think have been lost in this entire analysis.
Mr. Srinivasan, you didn't answer my question. Cricket is a public affair, and hence public interest is involved. Do you agree with that assessment? Therefore, public interest and national interest. Allow me to complete.
I do not know.
National interest is involved. The image of the country, which is represented by one sport the entire country is passionate about, cannot be handled by a group that runs itself as a closely knit private society. Don't you believe you need to fundamentally change that? And if you don't, then sometime in the future, someone will change it for you.
That's your view. But as far as I'm concerned, as I see it, the BCCI is running cricket well. You don't agree, what can I do?
And do you believe the BCCI and those running it don't need to answer to the people outside?
I think you talk as if there's a whole lot of things wrong in BCCI and people are not accountable. People don't feel. I don't think so. I don't agree. All the state associations, cricket associations, are members of the BCCI. I think a lot is being done to promote cricket, to develop cricket, to create infrastructure. I think if one looks at how today cricket is organized, I think amongst all, if you take all countries in the world, I think cricket in India is not only organized, it's developed and run quite efficiently.
I am not asking you about how cricket is organized. That's not the question. I will ask you this question one last and final time, Mr. Srinivasan. the question, the interview began with a call to your conscience. And my question to you was very clearly, not of the way that you want to argue it, because you know this, Mr. Srinivasan, you may get the world's most expensive lawyers, you may have the most finely tuned legal argument. At the end of the day, you will have to answer to your own conscience, and that's what's going to determine the way this thing goes. You stepped aside, Mr. Srinivasan, for a while, not because of the rule of law, because you felt the public pressure against you. People were angry. Did you not sense it then? At that point of time, did you not, people, when Vindu Dara Singh, Gurunath Mayappan, all that came about, did you not feel that the cricket lover out there was almost feeling cheated, Mr. Srinivasan? And that was happening under your tenure.
I don't agree with you, the fact that people had anger at me. No, that was not so. There was a lot of, I don't want to go into, I think I already said the media went overboard, so I don't want to repeat that. All I can convey to you is, I stepped aside because that was a decision I took until the report was completed. The report was completed, I was not involved, as I said, with the constitution of this probe committee.
Which really cannot be taken at face value, because you were the BCCI chief.
But I had stepped aside.
Well, you were still the BCCI chief. You had only discharged.
I'm sorry, I had stepped aside. I had just stayed away completely. And a working committee, when I was not present, anyway, I've said it, I've repeated it. I think we disagree on.
No,
this.
If a political party.
I think we disagree.
If a political party tomorrow were to be accused, an individual, major individual in a political party were to be accused of a major wrongdoing, and that political party was to carry out its internal inquiry and give the person a clean chit, tell me, Mr. Srinivasan, would you buy that line?
We can't. See, you can't compare the BCCI to a political party.
In fact, I would say it's more. You represent more of public interest. You represent more of
national
interest.
We disagree on this, sir. I mean, you can't compare the BCCI to a political party. That's all I can say.
So, penultimate question. If that probe panel, which submitted its report before the Bombay High Court verdict, 2 days before, were to give a verdict against Gurunath Mayappan, would you then have stepped aside? You then have completely stepped aside, Mr. Srinivasan?
Excuse me. These are speculative questions. You are asking, you are posing me, if this happens, what will you do? I don't have to answer all that.
No, because there's one follow-up
question.
One follow-up question, Mr. Srinivasan. If this next investigation in 4 months were to go against you, how can you leave that question?
I am not the accused. Let's understand one thing very clearly, sir. I am not the accused here.
But he's your son.
First, let me answer clearly to you. I am not the accused. Let us understand that.
But he's your son-in-law.
I am not accused.
But if it were to go against him, it doesn't tell on you.
I am not going to answer these questions, please. I don't think it is fair to ask such questions of me when I am not the person accused. And I do not want to go into this. I keep repeating that I do not want to discuss matters regarding this probe, because it is being a Supreme Court has, the highest court in the land has set up a committee. So I should not make any comment on it.
Mr. I can quite very well see from our conversation today, Mr. Srinivasan, that on many fundamental issues, you are unwilling to go into details. Your argument for that is that there are many matters which are still in the realm of the court. I would have encouraged you to go more on those subjects, because my argument is that these are matters which are still very much in the public domain. And I can only say that at one point of time, when you agree to speak in detail on each of these subjects, you will once again speak to me on Frankly Speaking.
I will. When the time comes, when I'm in a position that, you know, to address this in detail, I shall.
I'll wait till then.
All right.
Mr. Srinivasan, thank you for talking to me.
Thanks.
Thank you.